a little bit tempted to say, instead of doing this, where they end up, because I think it's almost interesting that the basement is, or the galleries are super rational.
Yeah, exactly.
Maybe with the possibility of having some kind of quality of daylight, but that can easily be cut off.
Yeah, that is quite straightforward, and that because we also do the phase two, that they could just send back the small pavilion. It's about like the simplicity is also like a bit more striking.
Yeah, I do think that the.
I mean,
but also it becomes tempting. In a way, when you imagine like how if this was green and this was somehow pavement, how would they merge? You could also really imagine that this one comes up like that, but then actually becomes, and this one comes up like this and becomes that. Do you mean that?
Yeah, like interlocking loops.
It's like the great thing about this is also just having this view over the garden. So I mean, that was incredible when you're on the site visit at the top here.
Yeah.
And you get an appreciation of the garden and the surrounding Adelaide Hills.
I say, you know, if the Botanic Garden really just comes, you know,
because then
the Botanic Garden comes here and climbs up there.
Because then the auditorium above, the outdoor auditorium, can also face the Botanical Garden.
And then in that sense, rather than this being the limit of the Botanical Garden, this and this and this. So then I would say the sculpture park is sculpture in nature and sculpture in a sort of more modern paved situation. It's not lifting up. It's clearly, you know, there'll be a path going through it.
Yeah.
But it just means that the nature somehow wins.